Good afternoon, everyone. This time, Judge, would you like to say the Pledge of Allegiance?
Let me call the roll, if I may. Mr. Delgado?
Present.
Mercury Martinez, present. Ms. Tita Cantu Vella? Is Ms. Cantu Vella on Zoom? No? Okay. Mr. Rangel, is he on Zoom?
Mr. Rangel, is he?
Not either.
I think they both may be late.
Okay.
They're both responding.
Hoping that we will be able to get them. All right, there are two present and two absent, Mr. Chairman.
All right, thank you, Judge, appreciate that. This time for the Pledge of Allegiance? There's an unnecessary.
Unnecessary?
Okay, all right. So we'll call this meeting to order. Thank you, everyone. This is the Laredo College District Finance and Audit Committee meeting. For the record, today is Tuesday, April the 6th, 2021. The time is 5:32. Roll call has been called by the judge. Thank you, Judge. At this time, we'll move on to agenda item 3, which is the approval of purchases of equipment through CARES Act funding. First subsection is going to be approval for audiovisual equipment and installation purchases from Audiovisual Aids of San Antonio. Mr. Luciano Ramon.
Good afternoon, everyone. Luciano Ramon, Information Technology Officer. Yes, sir, Mr. Delgado. We come to the board to ask for the purchasing of equipment for two different areas for the college. One is for the Protective Services Building at the South Campus. This is for AV equipment for the classrooms to allow the additional students due to the COVID situation, okay? And the other one is the purchase of audiovisual equipment for the more vocational building, which houses the electrical shops, amongst other items, here at the Fort Mac. We did the walkthrough with the dean of the area, Heriberto, and the faculty to find out what their needs were. And we brought in the consultant from San Antonio, and they were able to design a system for them. And we feel that this will greatly enhance and improve and help the students of both programs with the providing flexibility for the instructor for the instruction.
Thank you very much, Mr. Ramon. Judge, do you have any questions for Mr. Ramon? We'll move on to the second item, which is the approval of purchase of equipment for Transportation Technology Labs. Mr. Cesar Vela, you have the floor.
Good afternoon, members of the board. For the record, Cesar Vela, VP of Finance. The next items that we are requesting approval at the Thursday meeting are for the purchase of equipment for the diesel, for the Transportation Technology Labs. Mm-hmm. We are requesting the purchase of two diesel engines assemblies for diesel technology at an estimated cost of $17,127.39. In addition, we're also requesting two training vehicles for the automotive technology program at an estimated cost of $42,000. And we are requesting also the purchase of five Lincoln welding machines and eight Lincoln power MIGs and supplies, again, for the Transportation Technology Program at a cost of
$33,790.80.
17,127.39 for the two diesel engine assemblies.
So you're talking about 17?
17. Okay, 17,000, yes, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. And the last item, as I mentioned, are the Lincoln welding machines at a cost of $33,790. Again, this will be for the transportation technology programs. All these purchases are being made using CARES Act funding.
Mr. Vela, if I could stop you 1 second. Let the record reflect that Ms. Tita Vela is present on Zoom.
Uh,
Mr. Vela, just a real quick question with regards to the purchase of the training vehicles. I understand that we spoke last week with regards to attempting to reach out to some of the local entities that are here. I don't know if that was any type of success.
We haven't done that process yet, okay. Mr. Delgado. Again, once the board approves that, we'll start the purchasing process.
Okay.
I did receive the specs this morning from the dean of that area. And as soon as the board approves that, the purchasing office will make contact with the different entities, local entities.
And is it a requirement for just two vehicles as far as the purchase order, or can it be additional? And I guess my only question is just that if we're able to get some of the local vendors at a better price, so to speak, as far as for purchasing, is if it's necessary just for two, or if it could be done for more?
At this point right now, they're requesting only two. But again, if the board approves additional equipment and there's a need for it, we can certainly come back to the board and make that request.
We do have funds for that, Mr. Vela?
Currently, through the CARES Act funding, mm-hmm. we do have funding available, sir.
Okay.
Ms. Vela, I know you're just joining us. I don't know if you have any questions or concerns with regards to agenda item number three. You're on mute, Mrs. Vela. You're on mute.
I'm sorry. No, I don't have any problems with that.
Okay. If there are no other questions or concerns, we'll move on to agenda. Thank you, Mr. Vela. We'll move on to agenda item number four, which is the approval of Oracle licenses and support renewal. Chair recognizes Mr. Luciano Ramon.
There's two more items there.
Oh, I'm sorry.
The Industrial Technology Labs and the Law Enforcement Academy.
My apologies. I thought you had gone through those. My apologies.
Yeah.
We'll move to stick with agenda item number three on subsection approval for purchase of equipment for Industrial Technology Labs. Mr. Vela?
Yes. And this item is for the purchase of four hydraulic wrap-around benders for the Industrial Technology Program. At a cost of $35,223. And again, the purpose of this is to be able to provide additional equipment to be able to safely have social distancing between our students in those labs. And the final item, which is for the Law Enforcement Training Academy, is the purchase of a virtual arms training system at a cost of $97,098.10. This is being purchased from Inveris Training Solutions through GSA pricing. And again, the purchase of this training system will expand the capabilities of the Law Enforcement Training Academy. Currently, we have two systems available. With this, the additional two systems, we'll now have four, and we'll be able to socially distance our cadets there at the training center.
So you're looking at approximately $140,000in total cost between those two, Mr. Vela?
That's correct, sir. And if we take into account all the items, including the audiovisual equipment that was presented by Mr. Ramon, we're looking at a total of $357,867. And again, all of this equipment will be purchased using CARES Act funding.
Overall, 350?
357,867.
If the board, Mr. Vela, if you don't mind, if the board does approve these particular purchases, what balance would we have left for CARES Act funding?
We currently have about $10 million still from phase two.
Okay.
Indications is that we'll be receiving another round of funding.
Yes. Any member of the board have any other questions?
No.
All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Vela.
Thank you.
So, in effect, if I may, Mr. Vela, when we're looking at the total dollar figures between on all of those four items, what is approximately the total cost, more or less?
I'm sorry, for the items that we just presented?
Yeah, all of these four items that we actually have. In other words, the
357.
The audiovisual and then
357?
Yes, that's correct. It's the 357,867 for all the items.
No, but looking at all four items, the total dollar figure.
That's the amount.
Yeah, I believe so, but.
Yes.
That's correct. 357.
357,867, sir.
357.
357, thank you. Okay, that's a total. I appreciate, I stand corrected. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Vela.
Yeah, if you allow me, I.
Yes, sir.
As mentioned in the previous meeting we had with the officers, this equipment is in line with our growth plans and expansion in the South Campus, primarily, mainly, and secondly, also because of our plan to expand our transportation programs, which are going to be badly needed. And all of this is in line with the safety factor, and that's why it's justified through the CARES Act. And we're very fortunate and that we have ample time to expand it and a lot more. But our plans are to expand to more than double the size of our transportation programs in the South, and this will fit right in line with those plans.
Excellent. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Solis.
Yes.
We'll move on to agenda item number four, which is the approval of Oracle licenses and support renewal. Chair recognizes Mr. Luciano Ramon.
Everyone, good afternoon once again. Yes, Mr. Delgado, this is for the annual renewal for our Oracle database and licenses. This is the Oracle Software Maintenance and Support Service, which includes the licenses for the Oracle Database Enterprise Edition, which basically runs all our banner applications for students, ERS, and accounting, payroll, HR. All those applications are run on the Oracle database, along with the programmer licenses and the Internet Developer Suite licenses. This comes from the IT budget. This is a normally yearly budgeted item for the yearly renewal. And it's for $195,352.75.
Thank you, Mr. Ramon, appreciate
we
that.
Have to,
Ms. Vela, did you have a question?
We have to do this. I mean, it's banner.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah, I mean, it's a renewal. So.
We have no choice.
I have no problem.
Yeah.
And that's why we budgeted on a yearly basis for.
Right,
for the
right.
No, thank you very much, Mr. Ramon. Greatly
thank
appreciate
you, sir.
It.
Thank you.
We'll move on to agenda item number five, which is the February 2021 financial report. Chair recognizes Mr. Vela.
You received a copy of the February 2021 financial report with your board packet. I'll quickly summarize the information for you. As of February 28th, we have revenues in the general operating fund of $52,315,028, expenditures of $25,993,749. Our revenues as of February 28th are 89% of what we budgeted. We did record the budget modification that the board approved as part of the mid-year pay increase, and that budget modification totaled $660,224. So at the beginning of the year, we began with a budget of $57,999,320. Mm-hmm. The modified budget as of February 28 stands now at $58,659,544. Again, 89% of our revenue has been collected, 44% of our expenditures have been incurred. There are only one, there are two items in the revenue. One, the tax collections. Again, for the month of February, we did see an increase in the collections. We currently now have collected 98% of the budgeted tax revenue. We budgeted 95% collection rates. Currently now we have a balance of $696,633 to complete the fiscal year. As far as the tuition revenue, we do have, again, a reduction in tuition and fee revenue. As of February 28, we still have a balance of 4.4 million in that line item. A major part of that balance has to do with the 20% discount that was offered in the fall semester, as well as the fall momentum and spring momentum. The total amount of the discount and the fall momentum for fall and spring is 1.3 million. We are anticipating to collect that amount using the CARES Act funding. That is an allowable cost as part of that grant. So we should be recovering the 1.3 million that was offered as part of that program or incentive. In addition, any lost revenue for the year will also be collected through the CARES Act funding. And you will see those adjustments as we close out the fiscal year. We're currently working with the Department of Ed on making sure that we have all the documentation for the for us to be able to claim that lost revenue. As far as expenditures, again, no major variances to report at this point. We are on target based on our projected expenditures. For special appropriations, that is the EDC revenues of $84,411, that's 48%. Expenditures of $97,682. Again, this right now is based on state appropriations, so this is common to see as part of the fiscal year. You see that our expenditures exceed our revenues, and again, this is because of the schedule that we're following with the state appropriations. We should be on target by the end of the year to collect the revenue that has been projected. Auxiliary services, revenues of 1.4 million, expenditures of 420,000. Right now, a net change to our fund balance of $1 million. Restricted funds, again, revenues and expenses equal 20.8 million. And again, the major portion of the federal funds is our Pell Grants and our CARES Act funding at this point. Again, no major variances to report in that particular fund. Now, just to show you a quick comparison of where we were at last fiscal year, you can see there on the left column, that is the current fiscal year. For our general operating fund, as of February 28, we had 52.3 million collected. Last year at this same point, we had 54.8 million. That's a difference or a decrease of 2.5 million. And that was expected, and we budgeted accordingly for that reduction. And again, the major difference here is, again, is our tuition and fee revenue going down this fiscal year. However, again, because we projected that we were gonna have a collection rate of 95%, and at this point right now, our collections are now going to be at 98%. We should make that or offset that decrease in tuition and fee revenue with tax revenue. The other major thing is that we were not, when we worked on our 2021 budget, we were not counting with the CARES Act funding. CARES Act now, new direction has been that lost revenue is an allowable cost as part of the grant. So we will be claiming that lost tuition and fee revenue at the end of the fiscal year. So again, we'll see our revenues for this fiscal year adjusted upwards once we claim that lost tuition and fee revenue. Expenses, this year we're at 25.9 million. Last year we were at 28.1 million as of February. Also a decrease of 2.1 million in our expenditures. And again, we budgeted accordingly. We knew that we were gonna have possibly reductions in revenue. And again, the major decrease here of the 2.1 has to do with salaries. Again, part of the voluntary separation plan that the board approved for this fiscal year, we froze the majority of those positions. So we saw a major reduction in our salary and expenses. As of February 28, again, we can see that the net change for this year is 26.3 million. Last year it was 26.7 million. So it's a decrease of about 400,000. And again, we're pretty much on target, and this is just to see how our budgeting is working for this fiscal year. And you can see there that, yes, we did see that decrease in revenue. However, our adjustments in the expenditures were accordingly, are offsetting those decreases. And then the rest of the comparisons that you can see and the other funds were pretty much on target compared to last fiscal year. Again, we have a slight decrease in the special appropriations. Like I mentioned, this is more of a timing issue. We should be getting the revenue for the state appropriations within the next 6 months, and that should make up for those decreases that you're seeing right now. The auxiliary services, again, you are seeing a decrease, and again, this is attributed to the reduction in fee revenue. And again, the revenue has gone down by about $340,000, but again, our expenditures have been adjusted accordingly. Again, the expenditures are also down $458,000 for the year. Facilities Master Plan Phase 3 construction. We began the fiscal year with $24.4 million. We've had interest revenue for the year of $73,000, expenditures of $517,000 for a net decrease of $444,000. So our balance is, and I apologize, it's not as of November, it's the balance as of February 28th, is $23.9 million at this point. And again, we do have already the projects that have been identified. As a matter of fact, we're bringing one to the board this Thursday for approval, which is the roof improvement project at the South Campus. And here is our what I had mentioned about tax collections. Our tax levy for the year is $36.9 million. We have collected already $34.3. That's 93% of our tax levy. We have a balance of $2.5 million for the remaining 6 months. We had projected that collections were going to be 95%. At this point now, with the current collection rate that we're currently having, we're looking at about 98% for the fiscal year. So that additional revenue will help us offset any losses that we may have in tuition and fee revenue. However, like I mentioned, those reductions in tuition and fee revenue, we will be able to claim in through the CARES Act funding. And lastly is just the investment report. As of January 31st, we have investments of $104,753,938. Again, the bulk of it is in our general operating funds, $85.9 million, which includes roughly about $24 million for construction, the $3.7 for the endowment fund, and $15 million that is invested right now in the investment pool also. Any questions or any items that the board may want a clarification on?
Ms. Vela, do you have any questions for Mr. Vela?
No, I don't.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Mr. Vela.
Thank you.
Okay. We'll move on to agenda item number 6, which is the ratification of HVAC repairs for the Sigaroa Science Complex. Mr. Vela?
Yes, board members, this next item is ratification for the HVAC repairs at the Sigaroa Science Complex. We did have to move on and place an order for the equipment. As we are aware, during the winter storm, we suffered some damages to the HVAC equipment at the Sigaroa Science Complex. We have identified the damage. There is a lead time on the equipment, so we went ahead and moved and placing the order. It'll take about maybe 6 to 8 weeks for the equipment to come in. We are projecting that the building will be ready by May so that we can utilize it for the summer one and summer two sessions. The total cost of the equipment plus the installation is $197,400. Again, this will be a claim that we'll be putting as part of our insurance claim. Again, this was due to the winter storm. One of the supply lines burst, and obviously we had some water damage and damaged equipment. The work that will be done by training will be to replace the cooling coils in air handlers 3, 7, and 8, and the insulation that is part of the impacted, that is impacted by the coil removals. Also, the BFDs for air handlers 2 and 3 will be replaced, and the controllers in the mechanical room. That's in the first floor. Damage was in the second floor. The burst, I guess the equipment that was damaged during the winter storm was at the second floor. However, that all that water ended up in the first floor, specifically in this one mechanical room. And again, they will also work on making sure that the startup and commissioning of the new coils and the controls of the VFDs.
But Mr. Vela, I know that this was due to the freeze, that tremendous impact that it had all over the city, and obviously here with the college. Is there any kind of liability insurance that we have that maybe might be able to we submit a claim on that?
Yes, Judge. We do have our property insurance, and again, this is part of the claim that will be submitted to them. Okay. We are currently in the process of compiling all the costs, which include obviously the equipment, the replacement of the equipment, and also the cleaning and the drying of the areas that were impacted. All that will be included. We did do an inspection, obviously also to make sure that all the audiovisual equipment had not been damaged as part of the water damage. And again, that has been concluded. There were a couple of items that need to be replaced, and that will also be part of this claim at this time. Again, the purchase of the equipment and the installation services is being done through a buy board contract. And again, so the contract number 631-20. Any questions on this one item?
Judge, do you have any questions?
No, thank you.
And Mr. Vela, the claim has already been submitted with the insurance carrier, correct?
They have already been contacted, sir. Mm-hmm. Yes, and information has already been submitted. However, it's not has not been finalized yet.
Okay. There's if you can, would you please just update the board with regards to that claim?
Sure.
Especially for the amount.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Thank you very much. Okay, thank you, Mr. Vela. We'll move on to agenda item number 7, approval of contract for facilities master plan phase 3, roof improvements and soffit and LED lighting upgrades project. Mr. Vela?
This next item is the approval of the roofing project. So the facilities master plan phase 3. If you remember, the board approved this project as part of the reconsidered funds that were available as part of phase 3. The project entails the replacement of all the roofs at the South Campus, with the exception of the Billy Hall area, which has already been addressed as part of the Billy Hall project, and also excluding the new building, the Allied Health building. The total cost for this project, and I'm trying to get here, is $3,863,800. And again, the project entails a replacement or roof restorations for the following buildings, which is the Center Judith Seferini Library, the Academic and Advanced Technology Building, the Camilo Prada Child Development Building, Raquel Gonzalez Automotive Technology Building, Congressman Henry Cuellar Protective Services Building and J.C. Trevino Fitness Building at the South Campus. It also includes the roof restoration for the Fort McIntosh Bookstore Building, and also includes the installation of metal soffit and associated LED lighting at the South Campus. As you may remember, one of the major problems that we have at the South Campus is the pigeon problems that we have nesting at the under those soffit areas. So this project will address that problem. We're currently working on matching the LED lighting and the soffit items that we have at the new building, the Health Sciences Building at the South Campus. It also includes the painting of all the walkway and staircase hand railings at the South Campus. Originally, we had projected that, or we had budgeted $2.9 million for the roof restoration project and $325,000 for the soffit and LED upgrades. At the Thursday meeting, we're asking the board to approve the project at a cost of $3.8 million. $226,000 coming from the bookstore fund balance to address the bookstore building here at the south, at the main campus. The additional funding that is needed will be coming from the facilities master plan. We did have savings in the Maravillo Gym project and the cosmetology project here at the main campus. Again, the total cost will be $3,863,800. Again, the approval that we'll be requesting is the board approve the contract, and it is a TCPN contract with Tremco for the roof renovation project, as well as the soffit and LED upgrades at the South Campus and the bookstore building roof renovation project here at the main campus. The contract includes a 20-year warranty on the Tremco roofing, two-year installer warranty. The contract also includes field inspections for years 2, 5, 10, and 15 by Tremco. And right now we are allocating about $75,000 for contingency allowance for this project. Again, in case any unforeseen items may come during the construction aspect of the project. Any questions?
The overall cost is $3.8 million in there.
Yes, sir. $3.8 million. $3.6 million coming from the facilities master plan and $226,000 from the bookstore fund balance.
Thank you.
Okay. There's no questions from any members of the board. Thank you very much, Mr. Vela.
Thank you.
We will continue on with agenda item number 8, which is the Imaginarium of South Texas Agreement Terms. Dr. Ricardo Solis.
Yes, thank you, Chair. This is primarily just an update of the Imaginarium project. It's not going to be discussed on the board, but I asked Mr. Orlando Cepeda to come here as well. We have continued having discussions and evaluating the optimizing the cost and reducing as much as possible. And this, the latest is the sheet that you have before you, I believe. We're going to continue trying to find other avenues. But primarily, this project, we're going to continue evaluating it and then coming up with a final recommendation at next month's board meeting. So far, we have a total of the grand total, because we're going to absorb many of these costs, man hours and so on, is going to be $649,000 approximately, $650,000 to be more exact, to round it off. And so that's where we're at now. The only difference that we're going to have from the project, again, these funds are from the phase two that we have that was already approved by the board many years ago, the $402,000. The Imaginarium is going to be contributing $170,000, which is very generous, and so that's going to be their contribution. And the difference is $78,000 is what Loreto College will come up with additional, and that will be through savings that we have already discussed that we will be able to find in other projects.
That's primarily the summary of the project. I don't know if you have any questions or comments about the Imaginarium.
I think the only question I had was, is there any update with regards to the terms of the lease?
We're still finalizing that. They're very flexible to the term of the lease. We would be meeting with their board. I don't know if Mr. Cepeda has any final details with their board, but they seem to be accommodating to what we want.
Okay.
And that lease will consist, of course, into a long-term lease with them. But we still have to finalize that final detail. And I don't
thank
know
you, Dr.
Council, do you have any comments on that? I know we're still deliberating with them.
Yes. Board members, this is Rusty Muir, attorney for Laredo College. My understanding is there have been discussions on the non-legal level, if you will, that administration has been communicating with the Imaginarium. But once those general terms are finalized, we're going to take a look at a document and make sure that they're incorporated and that the college is protected.
Yeah. As I mentioned, in addition to the $170,000 that they're going to be gifting to us that will go to the project, they have been agreeable that to do a long-term contract, a monthly lease. And right now we're just finalizing the cost per square foot that they're willing to. And of course, we're coming up with something very reasonable because we do want them. They will be a good addition to the campus and to complement our awareness and our promotion activities that we have with the schools. And most importantly, it will complement what we really want to do in the very near future is to expand the environmental center, mm-hmm. which has been neglected. And also the reason why we're not in a big hurry to conclude this is because fortunately the Imaginarium has been able to obtain an extension, a 1-year lease at their present location at the mall. But they are committed to come here with us once we get the details worked out, and then we can begin the modifications of the building. We have the P14 building.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Solis. James, do you have any questions?
I do.
Chair recognizes Ms. Vela.
Who will be doing the work to get this building up to par? Will it be done in-house? Because it appears that it might be something we can handle in-house.
Yes, ma'am. That's the intent. That this is why. Yeah, we're doing most of it in-house. The contractor
Good.
Services will be in the sheet. I don't know if you received that.
No.
That has installation of from security alarm to mm-hmm. elevator to specific specialty areas. But we will be, as you are mentioning, using quite a bit of our people to be able to use this throughout the project.
We are putting an elevator in.
Yes, that is is required, and so we
Good.
Will.
Yes, that would be nice.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm all for it.
Thank you.
Judge, do you have any questions?
No questions at all.
No, I don't have
concerns. We're already addressed it, and that we had a chance to meet with Mr. Cepeda, so we certainly endorse and support what he has in mind.
Yes, definitely. Definitely exciting.
That's it, sir.
Yes, by all means. Yes.
No, thank you.
No? Okay. All right.
That's all I have. We'll give you a more thorough update in May meeting.
Okay.
Thank
all
you.
Right. Thank you, Dr. Solis. Mm-hmm. We'll move on to agenda item number 9, which is the bonding refunding update. Dr. Solis, Mr. Vela.
Yes, Mr. Vela, please. Yeah, we've been in constant discussion and meetings with our bond counsel, with Estrada Hinojosa, and for several months now. And finally, we've been able to conclude the refinancing of our bonds. And we're glad that we waited because the interest rates have gone down tremendously, and we waited until they finally actually went down even further, mm-hmm. and then we were able to lock it in. Mr. Vela, please.
Yes, as Dr. Solis mentioned, we're in the process of finalizing the refunding of $56.2 million of our general obligation debt.
Would you mind repeating that again, Mr. Vela?
Yes, we're in the process of closing on the refunding transaction of $56.2 million.
66?
56.
I'm sorry. 56.
56.
$56 million
savings?
No. This is the debt.
Oh, they're refunding the debt.
Yes.
Okay.
We're refunding $56.2 million of our general obligation debt.
And it will impact how much savings in interest?
Yes. The savings for this one transaction it will be $4.7 million. That's the net present value of the savings.
In other words, we're going back. It originally was we're going to save around 60. Now it's double that figure.
Right now, the savings would be 4.7, sir. Yes.
1.7.
4.7.
Thank you.
The current rate on the bonds that we're refunding is 5%. The new bonds, the interest rate will be 2.16%. Okay. Again, the transaction will be closing tomorrow. And again, the savings that are going to be, part of this process will be $4.7 million over the life of the bond of the new bonds.
Wonderful. Thank you. So we're very satisfied with this transaction.
Very good.
It's been months and months of meetings with them, and of the outstanding bond money is $56 million that the college has. And we approached Steinhausa to refinance it last year when we saw that the interest rates were reducing and were going down. And we have presently a 5% interest. Excellent. And now it's going down to 2.1. And we're very fortunate because we were about to lock it in a month ago at 3, and then we waited and it came down.
Now it's 2.1 interest that we're paying on those bonds. Man,
yes.
That's impressive. Incredible.
That will 4.7 million would be the savings and the life of the bonds.
Wonderful.
Remaining of the 56 million.
Definitely great news.
Excellent.
Does any members of the boards have any questions?
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Vela. Okay. At this time, please be advised, as just for the record, no action was taken on any of the items present. And at this time, if I could have a motion for adjournment.
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. Thank you. We have a motion. Do we have a second?
Ms. Vela, is there a second? Okay.
I'll take that as a second. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
I'm sorry. I was muted. I'll second.
It's okay. We have a motion. We have a second. At this time, we'll go ahead and adjourn. Thank you very much, everybody.
Thank you very much. That's a good meeting.